Right, morning. This is my first ever vlog, so it's not going to be great, I will warn you. I've decided that this year, rather than having New Year's resolutions, without giving any history, by the way, I've got a stinker of a cold, hence why I have this thing going on and sound so bleh. Yeah, without giving any history, last year was a tough one. For me, for my family, and from that, it kind of made me think, you know what, you have one life, and so this year I want to make as many memories as possible. Obviously, finances and things pending. I mean, I'm not on about just like swimming with dolphins or anything like that, but just making the most of moments and making the most of spending time with my family, and whether that's just a walk around the block. And taking in the fact that actually we live in an alright area and that kind of thing, or whether it is fantastic holidays. Admittedly, this is February, so January I started a blog, and I've been trying to pluck up the courage to start a vlog. So this is my first ever attempt. It is the 11th of February, and today me, my mum and my sister, maybe my sister's boyfriend, are going to go and see my middle sister, who's at uni in Lincoln. So Lincoln's about an hour and a half, 2 hours away. Mum's driving today. Normally I drive, but Mum's kindly going to let me rest and she can drive. So I'll see what I can film. I'm hoping I'll start doing weekly vlogs. Because I work full time, my days aren't really that exciting in the week. But hopefully, it might be something, we'll see. My hair is still wet, hence why it looks so lank and murky. But yeah, and as I'm still new, confidence and vlogging in public is something that is petrifying me. But hopefully this will actually make me more confident if I keep doing it throughout the year. Who knows? So we'll see what I can get, and then we'll let you know. Hello! So, my first day of vlogging yesterday wasn't that successful because, quite honestly, I forgot. Obviously, I still feel quite crap, as you can hear, and as the day went on, I felt worse and worse. So, by the time I got home, I was then going to show you what I bought, but I was so cold, so cold. I ran a bath, and I realised after when I went to go and turn the taps off of the bath, I hadn't even put any cold water in, and I still got straight in the hot bath and it didn't burn me or anything. I was so cold, and then I felt too hot, so I went straight to bed, and yeah, so yes, there was a bit of a write-off, but anyway, hence why I still look like this, because I've made myself a den downstairs with a blanket, watching Despicable Me and any other films I can find on telly, with a cup of tea and Lemsip and Vaseline on my nose and anything else. But I thought I'd show you what I got yesterday, and I wasn't going to film because I look so horrific, but then I thought, actually, if I'm going to keep this up, there are going to be days when you just actually see me at my worst, so let's just get it over and done with, hey? And if it's that bad, you'll all just switch off anyway, so hey ho. But my first stop of the day was the obligatory Primark, one of my favourite places in the world, quite honestly. I just love it. So the first thing I picked up, in Lincoln, for such a small place, they have such a good Primark. It's not massive, but you can almost always guarantee that if you cannot find a certain something in any other store, there was something over Christmas, and I went to both London stores, the Norwich store, Cambridge and Lakeside, and I couldn't get hold of a certain item for someone. Yet my sister could pick it up in Lincoln. Lincoln just seems to have everything, even though it was tiny. But they also seem to have the best Primark sale. So I picked up a basic cream jumper, which I have a little black kind of tartan or checked mini skirt that I wear, and I've also got a navy mini skirt, which I thought, oh, this will go quite nice. It's quite thick, it's quite simple, and it was £3. So thinking for a work basic, you can't really go wrong with that, can you? I also picked up, which I don't know if I'll keep, but I did like him. And does anybody else buy pyjamas to match their bedroom and bed covers? Or is that just me? Maybe it's just me. But there's some black silky pyjamas, which I just thought, I don't know whether I will actually like them. I've never owned a silk-esque type pyjamas before, but they match my bedroom. So, even if they just end up looking pretty underneath my pillow, then we'll see. But these were £10, actually, for Primark. I think that's quite expensive. But I did like them, so I invested in some of them. I also got myself, when I get it my way around, a khaki jumper. So I love this colour, being a ginger, this suits me quite well, and it was a real flattering shape, so it was quite fitted but not too fitted. It was more of a kind of a square cut, just get quite a wide neck as well, which I think can sometimes be quite flattering, especially if you've got a bigger chest like I have. And again, this was £10. But I thought green jeans with blue jeans, green jeans, with dark blue navy jeans. Again, they'd be quite nice, quite classic. With my brown little ankle boots, they'd go quite well. I also picked up. I was watching a video the other day of, who was it? Fleur de Force, I think. And she had just come back travelling, and she was saying she always puts her toiletries in a clear plastic toiletry bag, and at the airport when you have to get out your liquids and things, they never ever ask her to swap over the bag, whereas I'm always the person trying to cram it into them little plastic sandwich bags and snap it up and things split and what a nightmare. So I happen to see these in Primark. It's a set of three, so the biggest one's got is clear with kind of baby pink. Then you got a slightly smaller one which has got mint green round, and then the smallest one has got lilac. So I thought one might be able to go in my handbag and one as my main toiletry bag going away. But for £4, that's kind of like a pound each. So actually that's quite good. So I thought that'd be quite handy for any trips coming up. You never know, wishful thinking. I also, as I'm sure you'll end up discovering, I'm always cold. Always cold. And as a joke, some people for Christmas got me some socks called feet heaters from Primark. I've had some other wear of elsewhere, but to be perfectly honest, the ones from Primark are the best for me. And they all bought them as a joke, but I wear them on quite a regular basis and I think they're brilliant. So I saw, I mean, most of mine are actually quite funky colours because they were kind of a joke, whereas they had them in like pale pinky oatmeal colour and a grey. They're little ankle ones, so that's great. They go with my boots rather than having to come up too high up my legs. They were £2.50 and they've been reduced for £1. So I've got a pair in each colour. So they'll keep me toasty for a little bit longer. I also, let's see. Yeah, I think it's come to the end of the Primarky bits. I also picked up an eyeshadow brush for £1 because I have some Real Techniques eyeshadow brushes. I also have some Wilkinson's eyeshadow brushes, they're lovely and soft, and I got a separate Real Techniques eyeshadow brush set. But to be perfectly honest with you, the eyeshadow brush I always come back to is my Primark one, because it's flat. I don't like big poofy ones. I like them quite flat. I like a wide flat to do my main colour, and I like a thinner flat to do in the crease and, you know, and the shading on the outside. And to be perfectly honest with you, my Primark one does that the best. So rather than having to keep kind of wiping it and swap the colours, for the sake of the quid, I'll just get another one. And while I was there, I also got some mini sponges. I don't know if you can see them. I'm not into this whole beauty blender thing, although my sister was actually telling me that you're meant to dampen the beauty blender and then it might work better, which, who knew, maybe that's where I'm going wrong. However, I have been using the really little pointy sponge for my under eye concealer, because I find that stays and actually makes my eyes a bit brighter. So again, I have been washing them out, but for the sake of £1.50, I've got a spare one of them. And that was my Primark trip. I then went into Superdrug, which is a whole story in itself. The power of YouTube. Last week or so, I've been seeing loads of different people doing Lottie London reviews, makeup reviews. So that is, I ain't stupid. I work in PR and communications. So I know that it's because Lottie London have sent out makeup everywhere, and who knows if it's actually a genuine review or not. But it worked because it made me want to go and hunt it. Now, Lincoln has two Superdrug stores, both of which have a Lottie London stand. Sorry. But both of them were basically just full of lip balms or makeup brushes. It was utter crap. So if I want to try any Lottie London stuff, I'm going to have to order it online. But I might wait a little while and see if some reviews come in from people and actually see if they're any good. However, some other things that I have been having my eye on and had stock alerts on their website and they didn't have was some Makeup Revolution stuff, one of which was the Vivid Baked Highlighter. I've never really used a highlighter before, but I've heard good things. I was quite impressed with the size because it was £3, and so from the website I was expecting something diddy like an eyeshadow size. But that is a decent, you know, palm-sized highlighter. So we'll give that a go. And that was £3 in Superdrug. And then I've also got, which one was it in the end? The Iconic One palette. Don't know if you can see that. I was tempted between that or the Iconic 2 palette. So I'll put the Iconic 2 on my birthday. It's not till September, but hey-ho, a girl can dream. Which I understand is a Naked palette dupe. Now I do have a Naked palette somewhere, but it is fairly well worn. But if I can dig it out and compare it, I will let you know. So I'm quite excited about that. That when I need to cover up this again, then we can use that well. And I also then nipped into Poundland to get some essentials. So I picked up a deodorant. I need a new deodorant. I also got some cold and flu tablets, which I'm taking already. And the best thing of all, a white Toblerone. You cannot beat a white Toblerone. Normally you can only pick these up in the airport, and out of principle I refuse to buy them because they're like ridiculous amounts of money when you know they do Toblerones in Poundland normally. But normally they only do the normal ones, not the white chocolate ones. The only thing which has been a massive controversy, whether it's down to Brexit or not, I don't know, is that the gaps in between the little slices are actually now bigger. So you actually get fewer slices. But I don't care. For sake of a quid, which a normal little dairy milk's like 60p now. So a pound and you get a massive Toblerone that's bigger than my head. Brilliant. So that was that. Friday night, I forgot to show you, I also did some supermarket shopping. Now, I'm all for local supermarkets. I think they have amazing stuff. And on that note, I heard a little digger bird say that Sainsbury's are going to be having a 25% off from Tuesday for a week. And they've really upped their clothes game. They're really good at dupes now. So they've got some hoodies in, which are dupes of jewels, which I got for Christmas, and I've loved them. Got some boots, which were dupes of Kurt Geiger ones, which I tweeted. So yeah, so I'm excited. So if that does come off on Tuesday, I'll let you know, and we can go and have a little rummage. But while in Tesco's, these aren't very exciting. However, and maybe it's just because of how I'm feeling right now, I picked up some joggers. Now they're kind of creamy marley colour with little rose gold detailing. And who doesn't love a bit of rose gold right now? But the most exciting thing is they are so soft on the inside. I don't know if you're going to be able to see that, but they are so fleecy warm. I just thought, oh my god, these will be amazing. So I picked up the bottoms, and I've also got the matching hoodie, as you do. So I don't plan on actually going out in it at all. I don't plan on going out for the next month and how I'm feeling right now. But I'm mega excited to wear this. At the moment I'm still in my gym jams with just a cozy snuggly jumper, pyjama hoodie on. But I may have to swap this later to try it, but I wanted to show you guys first. But yeah, so the top was £12 and the bottoms were £10, which to be honest I thought was a bit of a splurge, but if I'm going to be wearing them for the rest of my life, then that's quite a bargain. Now, and the final thing, which I then got at the end of the week, is anyone, or as you will soon discover, I love stationery. Always have done, always have loved September as my most favourite time of the year, not only because it's my birthday, but because you would always then get your new stationery to go back to school, and I loved it. As a kid, you'd go into Woolworths back then, ask your mum if you're too young. And in Felixstowe, that was the place to go, and I could go and pick a new pencil case, a new ruler, a new pencil, a new rubber. I loved it. And that feeling has never faded. Even with new jobs, I get new stationery. It's amazing. Now, I got my new job back in October, but the excitement of my new stationery for my new desk still hasn't waned. And with this whole new rose gold theme going on, it seems to be everywhere. But the stationery, Sainsbury's have really upped their stationery game. It's been amazing. So, I have invested in a brand new rose gold notebook. I definitely don't need one, but it was so pretty. It's lined. I'm all for a lined notebook. I can't be doing plain pages. I need something to line on, and that was beautiful. That was £4, so that was quite excessive. I also got, I just dropped one, were two little jars of, this one's got rose gold paper clips in a rose gold little mason jar, which I just thought the jar was as cute. They've also got some bulldog clips, so some are marble, some are rose gold, and again in a little mason jar, and I believe these are £1.50. I can't find the receipt, so that's not much use to you at all. But yeah, these were either £1.50 or £2. I'll link them below. In the same range, I also got a to-do clipboard, so it's got marble on the back, rose gold clip on the top. This was £4 as well, but I just thought this was epic. Again, everyone used to always take the mick out and say that was like Monica from Friends when she was organising Phoebe's wedding with the headset, and oh, this would just be me down to a T. And then to go with that, there was also a nice rose gold ball pen. So I thought, ooh, they'll look nice together. That's very Instagram-ish for my desk. And to be perfectly honest, if you don't have nice stationery, what else is there to inspire you? You're at your desk for a long time and, you know, many hours of the day. So you've got to make it exciting, haven't you? All in all, that is it, really. I'm not planning on going out anywhere. I've sent the husband out to go and get me some more tissues because I've run out. And a newspaper. Got to have a Sunday newspaper. Love a bit of trash on a Sunday. And I plan to carry on staying on the sofa with my blanket watching some films. But I said yesterday I was going to start vlogging, so I didn't then want to give up after a day. I thought no matter how pants I am feeling and how horrific I am looking and how insulting that is to your eyes right now, I am sure. Let's give this a go and we'll see. And hopefully I'll feel better soon. So I'll speak to you soon. Morning! Right, so I've got you in my steering column, so I'm not actually quite sure how legal or how successful this will be, but we will see. At least you can hear me. It might actually be a better angle for you if you see a steering column and not me. So it's Monday morning, it's about 8:15. I was hoping to leave by 8, so I'm running late, which is standard for me. I'm actually at not my normal office this morning, and I can't really say I woke up feeling much better than I have done all weekend. I spent all day yesterday on the sofa. However, I am presenting to the senior management team on behalf of a colleague, so I didn't really feel like I could, you know, call in sick today. So we'll see how I do. I can always then come back home early because it is only like 10 minutes down the road. I've also got with me a bag of supplies in that I've got my own box of tissues just for me. I've got a box of tissues to replace the poor ladies who I used up and whose desk I borrowed on Friday, and I've also bought my anti-bag wipes because I kind of feel that that's necessary. I don't know what else there is to tell you. I've make-upped up to the max today, doing whatever tricks I could find to make me look human, So I've tried a new highlighter, which is a recommendation from my sisters from Makeup Revolution, which I think I showed you yesterday that I bought at Lincoln on Saturday. I've also used that highlighter in my brow bones to try and waken myself up a bit. I have also then taken the eyeshadow that's in my crease, which is also the Makeup Revolution eyeshadow that I used, that I bought on Saturday, under my waterline, again to try my eyes wider. Not used black eyeliner on my top or my bottom. And I've used a shitload of concealer, highlighting one under my eyes, so that number 7 Wow, which is my favourite under eye concealer ever. And then my collection one on the inside here, also to cover up where I slipped with my mascara wand. So that's always handy. I completely forgot, but I have a feeling I've got the hairdressers tonight after work. So it is actually quite handy that I'm working in Norwich today, because it then means I can get to the hairdressers on time and I don't have to leave work early. Because if I'm in Elsham, my normal office, that's like a good half hour away. So yeah, I'd have to leave slightly earlier. But who knows, get my hair, although bad timing, I've got a week to go till payday, so that wasn't the best scheduling by myself in terms of finances, but who knows, that might actually make me feel a bit better. And you get a free cup of tea and a biscuit, so that's always good. What else to say? In terms of lipstick, today I'm wearing one of my favourites, which is Twig by Avon. It's one of my favourite colours ever, and I am a MAC lipstick lover. Their lipsticks just seem to last all day and are amazing. However, I've gone in there several times, both in the Norwich store, which is right beside Jarrell's, for anyone who knows Norwich, and when we've gone travelling in airports and that, and no MAC consultant can seem to match my Twig lipstick in terms of colour. The closest I've got is Retro, but that's still a bit too ready, so I do like Retro, but it's not a Twig. It's not a Twig. And that has actually been on offer recently, so 2 for 10, so I've placed an order for that. And who cares whether it's MAC or Avon? I'm rambling now, aren't I? Sorry. I'm nearly at the office. Well, after all the diversions, it's haircut time! Woo! Eek, hair complete! So, colour done, cut done. Let's see if we can have a bit more professional me. Right, home for tea now, because I am starving. Morning! So it's Tuesday morning. Still feeling slightly crappy. So again, layered on all the makeup that I can to make myself look human. So I am still wearing my Makeup Revolution makeup palette. It's actually Valentine's Day, so happy Valentine's Day. And I'm off out tonight. I'm being taken out to one of our friends' restaurants, which no, we really love the food, so that's good. Call me up in a mum, so I'll take you with me there later. But I just wanted to do eye makeup that I then didn't really have to do a lot to later. And I've also stuck on a primer, so hopefully that will last. I've got this short hair, I don't know whether you can see it a bit better now than last night. So I went for a bit of a chop last night. So hopefully that might be easier to manage and try and get this new professional me. And we'll see. In terms of outfits, I have got my, oh, let's move out the light, it's a bit bright. I have my Primarni scarf, which was an absolute bargain. It was £4, and I actually ended up getting three in different colours, because there was one from Lisa Angel, who is like an online retailer but comes from Norwich. So she has a market stall in the middle of one of our shopping centres. And I loved the scarf, but it was £22 and it was square. So for someone who's little like me, it'd actually be quite hard to wrap. Whereas these scarves were £4 and I got three of them. So for £10 less, I actually got three scarves. But today's one, yesterday I wore my navy one, and I wore, I can't remember, I think I wore a navy one on Saturday's one. I did wear a colour one, I can't remember which one. And today's one is like the beige and grey one. I don't know if you can see. I've then got my kind of oatmeal duster camel coat, which again was an absolute bargain. That was from Primark in the sale, reduced from £25 to £10.
which can be a bit boxy, but I actually think it's actually quite nice for work. I have my bargain £3 Primark jumper, which I bought at the weekend when I went to Lincoln. I've just got some Sainsbury's trousers and then some of my absolute, let's turn this round so I can show you some shoes of mine. Oh, I don't think I can. So these are just black kind of kitten heels, very Kurt Geiger-esque. I've got some higher heels in bright blue, which remind me of the Manalo Blahnik ones in the Sex and the City film, which is why I got them. But these ones aren't Kurt Geiger at all. They're complete and utter dupe from a website called everything5pounds.com. So for me, they were a bargain. So yeah, so happy Valentine's Day. Let's go to work. Let's see what today brings. Bye! Evening. So tonight, it is Valentine's Day. So we're going out for a meal at the Open at Mum's. It's quite a kind of casual, comfy place that does really nice food. So trying to get an outfit that's in between. So I've gone for my bargain £7 navy suede pointed shoes from Dorothy Perkins, which were reduced from £25. I got them last week. Some Wonderfit jeans from George at Asda. Now I have to say, these are some of my favourite jeans. They really do not like lose their shape, and they hug you in all the right places, and they're super, super comfy. I've then just got a nautical style sleeveless shirt top from Primark, and as is the blazer. I wear a blazer all the time. I'm probably going to do my hair half up, half down. But yeah, that's it. So we'll see you a bit later on. Bye! Evening. So I was about to watch some YouTube, but instead I thought I would do some YouTube. So it's only a quick one. I'm just home from work and now starting tea, and tonight we've got pizza chicken. So if any of you are on Sleeping World, you'll know exactly what I'm on about. So they were homemade chips, so all you have to do is chop up some potatoes, toss them in fryer light and shove them in the oven for half an hour. And then cook your chicken breasts like normal, but 10 minutes before the end. Take them out, put on some passata. I prefer the Pizza Express passata, I just think it's got a bit more taste. And then chop up whatever vegetables you want like you would on a pizza. So I think we're literally just having whatever's left. The other night we had ham and mushroom, but we've got no bacon or ham left. So we've now got mushrooms, peppers, there might be some sweet corn about. And then I'll put a little bit of mozzarella on the top and cook that for the final 10 minutes. And there you are, pizza chicken. And then tonight I think we've got that broccoli and green beans as well. So how's your day been? Mine has been fairly dull, if I'm honest. I've got things like annual reports and stuff to write for work, so it's not always the most thrilling thing. However, there is another project I'm working on to do with a charity, and that has got some exciting developments happening. So I had a meeting with them at lunchtime, so that's good, but unfortunately, like the true blogging star that I am, I can't actually share with you any of the information as yet. But hopefully come June time, then we can start sharing a bit more, which would be good. What else is there to update you on? I did place a Lottie London order with Superdrug, so no doubt you'll see that when it arrives. I also did place an order with Sainsbury's to clothing, because they have got 25% off. So there was a skirt and a jumper I had my eye on for a little while. So I did place an order for that. And I also placed an order, considering I've got no money, I've got a bit spendy happy actually thinking about it, placed an order on Asda because there's been a bedding set up and after for ages, and they got out, it went out of stock for, well, about last month or so. And it's a tortoise bedding, because anyone who knows me knows we do have a pet tortoise, which at the moment he's little George, is currently hibernating and doing very, very well actually. In terms of, he's not losing much weight and he's sleeping all the way through. He's done about 9-10 weeks now, which is brilliant. So I also ordered that. So as and when they arrive, I will let you know. And then the other really non-fascinating bits and pieces to tell you was I actually did use my Beauty Blender damp today, and it did apply a lot better. So thank you, Abby, for giving me that piece of information. I'll give that another go tomorrow. I still do seem to have a bit of a shiny face today, but I'm not quite sure if that's to do with the powder or what, or just that's just what will happen with this foundation after a very long day. Who knows? So today, because I'm not wiping my nose a lot less, I have gone back to my number 17 Wow foundation, Stay Time foundation, which to me is exactly like an Estee Lauder dupe. The only thing about it is because it's so thick, if you are constantly wiping your nose like I was last week, then you do end up with massive, very obvious patches around by your nose, where you can almost see the wall of foundation and from the rest of your face as to where it then should be, which isn't ideal. So I then swapped to a bit of a lighter foundation because, let's be frank, I was looking hideous anyway, so whether it was less coverage, it really didn't matter. And that really is the only exciting information for you. I did, I completely forgot to film at the meal last night, or actually no, that is a lie, I did remember, but I didn't really feel comfortable doing it, sorry. So I didn't do it. But the meal was lovely, up to its normal high standard. Probably wasn't actually the best meal we've ever had there, I have to say. However, but I think that's down to personal taste more than anything else. But it's a nice atmosphere, it's really good quality food, good value for money. So yeah, so that's always good. I think that's all there is to tell you. I'll see if I can insert some pictures of dinner after, so you can actually then see what I'm on about in terms of pizza, chicken. But to be honest, I still feel quite crap, which I feel like I'm a bit of a broken record. I've never known something to last so long as this wretched cold, but I still ache all over. I should have gone to the gym tonight, but quite evidently I haven't. So what I would really like to do, to be honest, is get in my gym jams and have a bath, watch a bit of YouTube, put on a face mask, and just hopefully try and get rid of these aches and pains. But we'll see. All right, I'll speak to you later. Bye. Hello. So today, I actually had a meeting at the hospital, and now I've got another meeting in the city. So in between, I was going to pick up some bits and pieces that I need to do. So I've just whipped into Wilko, which I think is one of them places that is completely overlooked for homeware and things like that. So I'm going to have a wander around. There's some such pretty things. That's such good prices, actually. Oh, that vase is nice. Nice one, my wings actually. That's tall enough. Kitchen. Nice as well. Very nice shaped glass. Hey, okay, we're going to go into Super Drug to pick up a parcel. Oh, we're back to Chapel Hills, yeah. Oops. It's been a bit more than a little. Errands completed, so I'm now making my way to the other side of the city for a lunch meeting, and then I'm off to the south office, so I don't think there's much of the meeting I can actually film, just because of confidentiality and stuff like that. But that's errands all done, so I've picked up my Superdrug parcel with my Lottie London makeup in, so I can show you that later. I've got some nice home bits from Wilko. I also got some half price pick and mix, naughty, which I'm hoping to have after I obviously lose Fat Club tonight, or Chub Club, or whatever, all the other terminology that I got told off for calling it. And hopefully that'll be a positive result tonight. I kind of fancy the cinema. I think it's just because I picked up some pick and mix, but it's Thursday, so it's not a meerkat movie night. We'll see. I'll see what the boy says. But okay, I'll chat to you later. Bye!
sat down meeting my friend for a bit since lunch. She's just gone downstairs to order. We've actually come to a really nice place on Timber Hill. It's the gluten-free cafe, because I'm actually allergic to wheat, so it's really thoughtful of Esther to say, oh, let's meet here. The menu is fantastic. You can have alcohol, not that I am, because it's lunchtime and I'm working. Chai lattes, which I absolutely love, and Starbucks seem to be the only place that do them. All sorts of toasted sandwiches, cold sandwiches, all wheat free, a lot of stuff is vegan as well if you're into vegan, and a really good price. So once it arrives I will take a snapshot and I'll show you it. But and we are in, let me see if I can actually show you. We have managed to get a table upstairs, like, all by ourselves. So although downstairs it's absolutely round, it's a cute little place and there's a little shop as well, so you can buy some wheat free goodies if you're that way inclined. So yes, you've got drinks and milkshakes, breakfast, and lots of sandwiches and wraps. So for someone like me who is a little bit wheat inclined, this is amazing. Evening! I hope we had a good day. So it's been a rather long day for me. Just one of them days where anything that could have gone wrong did, but hey ho, it's over now and it's done. I've been to Chub Club. I stayed the same, but maybe I did deserve that actually after a couple of McDonald's at the weekend when we went to Lincoln. Eek. New week, fresh start. Anyhow, I wanted to show you, because I seem to have gone on a bit of a mini retail unexpected trip today. So as you saw earlier, I was in the city, I had a meeting in the city, so I just wanted to do a couple of errands beforehand, which included picking up my parcel from Superdrug, and putting a check in the bank, and I also had something to pick up from Wilkinson's as well. But while I was in Wilkinson's, I picked up a few other bits. Oopsie daisies. So first thing is first, let's do the Wilkinson's bits because there's more of them. So I picked up this vase, as you saw, for £10. Now the aim is, and I'll show you these, is to put some lighted twigs in. And these were from Wilkinson's actually. I bought these just before Christmas. And they're battery operated, as the picture shows. They then light up, and I think these will look rather pretty. I do have two sets, however, I don't know if both sets will fit in the vase. It might end up being that the other set I'll have to put somewhere else in the house. But I'll show you a picture of these when these are set up, and these will go with my colour scheme in my living room, which is kind of black and cream and golds and bronzes and those kind of colours. I also picked up one of these, which isn't very exciting, but if you're in a home, then for me, this, that kind of thing is. I love it. These used to be 10 odd pounds, but they were reduced to £4 in Wilkinson, so I thought that was a bargain. And the colour scheme, again, will go actually quite nicely in my upstairs bathroom. And I keep putting rear diffusers and things like that in, but because the door is open a lot of the time, like if no one's in it, then I kind of find the scent just goes, so they don't really have that much effect. Whereas if you put something like that in the downstairs toilet where the door is shut predominantly, then you do get a nice hit of smell, nice smell, when you first walk in. So I've got this for upstairs, and that was £4.50 from Wilkinson's, so I thought that was a good buy. And it also had my favourite scent in, which is the barley, sandalwood and jasmine. Now, I also picked up a couple of kind of face packs and things. So the first one is a black seaweed peel off mask, which I'm hoping this will be like the other black charcoal one that I use, though slightly less painful hopefully, but might clear out my skin, because this is for oily, greasy and combination skin, and I do have oily skin, so I'm hoping this will help. And then I also picked up a hair mask, because I've not seen one of these before. But also because it was a coconut mask, and I love coconut. I love the smell of coconut and vanilla and those kind of things. So I'm thinking one night in the bath, maybe a Saturday night, maybe we'll see what we get up to. I can have a mask and a hair mask on at the same time in the bath and just have a proper chill out. So, on that coconut Note, I also picked up a coconut and vanilla bath bomb. I believe these were pretty cheap. I'll have to, let's see. It was in fact 95p, so less than a pound. Less than you could actually buy one of them from Poundland. And I hear these are quite good. And it did actually smell quite nice through packaging alone. So I might even actually split that in half, because that is quite a big bomb. But we'll see. See how that goes. I hope that that can go in my Saturday night pamper as well. I also picked up some big Tresemme shampoo and conditioner. And these were only £2.45. I normally go to a Poundland, a big Poundland in the city, because they also do these big bottles, but not for a pound, which I find quite a con. They are normally about £2, £2.50 in there as well. So while I was in Wilko, rather than going walk up somewhere else, for about the same price, I picked up these, and they last for ages, just because they're so big. I also picked up some sweeties, which I might pack into tonight. And I was completely not a sucker, because I picked these up at the till, so I hadn't even planned to get them, and they just get people like me. I did, however, plan to get some pick and mix, because they're half price right now. So I've got some Haribo strawberries, or the straws. I've got them, there's the plain and the fizzy ones, because they are, both of those are my favourites. So I picked up some of those, and I thought, oh, these can then mix in with them. So I've got some yogurt raisins. So rather than like the normal chocolate or peanut raisins, I've got the yogurt ones, because in my head they'll kind of help you, maybe. And I also got some chocolate, sea salt and caramel fudge, but they look like, anyone who's old enough to remember, poppets. And I thought these looked pretty cool and pretty tasty. So I might actually open some of these and put them in my pick and mix. And then all I need is a film. And yeah, I feel like I'm at the cinema tonight. Then the actual thing I went into Wilkinson's for, probably should have actually opened these before I started chatting to you, because I'm not sure how I'm going to get in this, is I heard some good things about a primer, so I was after this for a little while, and another tale is that Wilkinson's really mucked up with a Christmas order of mine back in November, so as anyone who knows me knows, and as I'm sure you guys will learn, I love to do Christmas shopping early. I kind of tend to do it throughout the year, and I just get really excited about it and collect stuff as I go. But I placed an order, and essentially they charged me, but never actually gave me the goods. And after lots and lots and lots of chasing, I finally got my money back, but not through loads of hard work. So they actually did give me £5 voucher to spend online or in store, and I've never seen this in store, and I've been in three different stores now hunting for it. However, it is online, and it is the Prime of Your Life primer, and it's meant to be a mattifying primer. Oh, sorry, light reflecting primer. It is mattifying as well. The packaging is very like Soap and Glory esque, but the reviews of it is phenomenal, and it's only £3. So I've actually bought two of these, so with my £5 voucher I only had to then spend £1. So I was picking up these. So perhaps I'll actually do a video of how this works out. But the other package I picked up was my Superdrug package, which I showed you. You saw me picking up earlier, and I did tell you I'd ordered some Lottie London bits and pieces. So I am mega excited. And I have to say, actually, the Lottie London stand in... it was the St. Stephen Street branch in Norwich that I went to, did have several of the things on the stand. So had I gone there first, then I would have never had to order online anyhow. But it's still quite exciting. So I have got the... Oh, and they've all got bits and pieces around them. I've got the Blush Crush in colour Zane, as that seems to be the one that everyone seems to have. So we'll give that a go, so I'm quite excited. I then also got Slay All Day Lip Kit in colour TBT. That actually says Fleek. That's interesting. I think I've been sent the wrong colour. Hmm. leave that with me. We might have to sort that one out. I've got the Arch Rival, which is a shape and highlighter pencil in colour light for your eyebrows. Although, actually, look... Oh, no, that's a highlighter pencil. I was going to say, oh, that looks a bit light. That's because that's the highlighter end, Emma. Nice and stupid girl. So again, we can give that a go and see what that's like. And then because I spent over £10 on Lottie London, I then got a free Wing Woman liquid eyeliner. So that'll be nice to give that one a go. So we can try them together. I did think I'd ordered the Slay All Day lip kit in TBT, but I seem to have got Fleek. So we'll have a look at that. I'm not actually quite sure what kind of colour it is. Perhaps they just thought Fleek would suit me better. I don't know. It's all sealed up. We'll see. It's kind of a... So it is a kind of me colour. We'll see. I'll have a look at that online. I'm not sure about that. I also picked up the Makeup Revolution liquid eye primer. Again, the reviews online is what encouraged me to buy it, and it was £3. I did pick up one from Primark a week or so ago, mainly because I had, and I have done a blog post on it, but actually I might do a video on it as well, that might help, on some of their lipsticks, and I picked up two lipsticks and a lip liner. And swear to God, they've been amazing. They were 90p and they've been brilliant. Like, don't get me wrong, they don't last all day. They're nowhere near a MAC lipstick. However, for 90p, their longevity is brilliant. So I kind of then got on a bit of a roll and bought their eye primer. Don't bother with that, because that was a pile of cack. It just... literally, it was wet and it just sat on my eyelids and didn't dry, and then I stupidly attempted to put eyeshadow on and it was almost like I was just creating paint. Awful. So I'm looking at then going back to the product I did also then go on to buy. Based on the Superdrug reviews, I then also bought this. So we're going to give this a go, and for £3. What's wrong? You know, can't go wrong really. And then finally, oh no, not finally at all, but they kind of go together. I bought a Real Techniques foundation brush because it was reduced to £6 from like £9 something. But it's angled and it's quite slim. So I was thinking this would be fantastic to do some contouring with. Now, I'm really new to this contouring malarkey, as you all have discovered with me actually learning to dampen my sponge, which has been fantastic, apart from it just looks like everything's fell off my face tonight. And I swear I'm not as shiny as this in real life, is what the camera's showing, but hey ho. But I want to try this contouring thing because I think the effects are amazing when you do it right. What I'm scared of is that I will look okay in the mirror or on camera or those kind of things. However, in real life, I'll look like a zebra with stripes going up and down my face and people will look at me going, what the fuck? So again, Makeup Revolution, brilliant brand, great reviews online, which is what encouraged me to buy it. And it was £3.50, I want to say, £3.50, I'll link it below. And for that, I got a highlighter, a blusher, and like the contour bronzer colour. So I think, well, they're obviously designed to go together, and you've got three products for £3, and I've now got the correct tool to try and do it with. So we'll give this a go and see what happens. And that's all I've got today. So bar this potential mishap with the lipsticks. Oh, I'm gutted about that. I swear I did put Slay All Day. Oh, it's called Slay All Day. So that's that's not the name of lipstick. Oopsies. Well, we'll see them. This might be worth a go. I'll let you know. But hopefully, perhaps I'll do I won't do a tutorial because I can't actually teach you anything about makeup. Because you probably know more than me. But perhaps we'll have a getting ready with me and we'll just have a chatty get ready makeup session, as if we're getting ready for a night out and yeah, a chat and a cup of tea maybe. We'll see. But that's me done. My tea is cooking. I've got sweet potato fries and some corn, garlic and parsley sausages. And then with some green beans. I'm quite excited about that. And I'm then going to settle down with some of my pick and mix as Mark is working late tonight, so I then have a TV to myself. Yay! You might notice I've got my new hoodie on from Tesco's that I showed you the other day. It is so warm and so cozy. It's brilliant. And yeah, that is everything. See you soon. Bye! Morning! So it's now Friday morning. One of my new staff engagement concepts is to offer people bacon and sausage wraps, which I'll either go and get collected or pick up or deliver. So it's been a slow pickup this morning, but while I'm waiting for them to be cooked in Elsham, I'm gonna go and get myself a coffee. So here is Biddy's, one of my favorite places for afternoon tea, and they do the most amazing chai tea latte, so I'm gonna get myself a takeout and not be naughty and have a bacon bar.
Sorry, darling.
No, you're fine.
Don't stop, we'll get into the cakes.
Right, I've picked up my coffee. I also picked up a cheeky cake, which I said I wasn't going to get a bacon sandwich because I was going to be good. So I picked up a cake instead. Go figure. We're now going to head over to Flour and Bean to pick up the sausage and bacon wraps that the guys have ordered. We'll see how this staff engagement initiative goes down. But welcome to the wonderful little town of Elsham. So I'm actually off to my first blogger event tonight. Not quite sure where I'm going. I think it's here. So I'll see what I can film.
What I love about it, aside from the fact that it's a water-loving cleanser, so as you saw, it foams up beautifully, it's really easy to use, squeezes eye makeup off really well as well. It's very rich in an ingredient called hyaluronic acid. So hyaluronic acid is actually a natural component of the skin, and it's all about moisture binding, so it attracts and binds.
Just home from the UME skin event. I look a bit pink. So I had my first ever facial. It was absolutely amazing. I will do a proper update on how it all was, but to be honest, for now I am shattered. It's been a long week. I'm hungry, I'm tired, but I am so relaxed. That was just incredible, and it was so nice to meet other people as well. So yeah, I'll give you a full rundown tomorrow when I'm feeling a bit more human.